Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me once again. Please like, share, and subscribe. Well, that didn't take very long to happen after I reported about the three earthquakes there in the Gulf of California near Baja, California. I told you how that location often was an indication of a larger earthquake to happen, and so it did. At 3:02 a.m. today, November 4th, 2022, there was a magnitude 6.1 earthquake there in the Gulf of California. Going to the USGS website, down here is the 6.1. This one here, and this one here, and then that one here is what I reported. I guess they decided to downgrade them. This last one here that I reported last night or yesterday afternoon, that actually was a 3.5. Looks like they downgraded it to a 3.3. The next one that happened before that, they had it as a 3.4. Looks like they downgraded it to a 3.3. And then this one, they did not change that one. That one was a 3.1, and I did a report about that. What you need to worry about is, this is part of the San Andreas Fault Zone. Going up towards San Diego, the Los Angeles area. And we got one here recently, a magnitude 2.2. Let me go back to Google Earth. Here's the location of that earthquake. Now, this area is a spreading basin. It moves about 2 inches per year towards the west. What happened with this earthquake is it moved west and also towards the north. Let me bring this out because I want to talk about these fault zones. And yes, any earthquake can trigger even a larger one on adjoining fault lines. Let's see. Let's bring this out. Okay, we got the San Benito fault zone, and the 6.1, yeah, it was between that one, and it's actually all one fault zone, but they break it up into different names, and I'm not going to even try and pronounce it. So let's go up, because I was talking yesterday about the Rose Canyon fault zone there in San Diego. And I hope everyone is prepared for a larger earthquake. Let's go back over here and see what earthquakes we got more recently. This is probably one of the larger ones that has occurred in a while. Now, there was a 7.0 in 2012, April 12th of 2012. So this is one of the probably largest one that they've had, what, in 10 years. Seeing how this is November 4th, 2022. And that was in 2012. I do not see any aftershocks on the stream view. I'm going to download this and then we'll make it larger. All right, I believe it is this monitor right here that will show one of the earthquakes that occurred yesterday. Yeah, right there. Right there. I didn't do this yesterday, show you this, because it was so small on this monitor. All right, let's go back. We'll reduce that, and we'll go to these earthquakes here. And we'll go to the spectrogram. Okay, yeah. Yeah, let's see, let's go to where it started, right there. This one here is actually the better monitor. And as you know, because of spreading, because it's a rift zone, yeah, you have magma down below, and that's what you're seeing here. We'll make this one bigger. Like I said, I do not see any aftershocks, and USGS is not reporting. Well, there could be a little little one buried in there, but it rattled for so long. And maybe another little one there. Let's go to the seismic signature. Another one there. Well, looks like it'll show up better on the spectrogram. Right there. So there's probably three, maybe very small aftershocks, but it's hard to tell because it rattled on for so long. Look at that. They did not fudge about the size of this earthquake. Let me bring this over a little bit, and I'll bring it down. Let's see. I get a magnitude 6.07. It was 6.2 miles deep. Now, they're saying it's larger than what I got. They gave it an intensity level of 5. And let's see. Here's some of the felt reports. Hermolis, I guess you can say. Intensity level 4. Intensity level 4 there. Now, okay, this one was intensity level 5. That would be Guamas, which meant that they felt it by most people in that location. They had some breakage of dishes, maybe windows, plaster, disturbances of tall object. Now, this is the magnitude, so it would have been like a 3.5, maybe a 4 in their location. But let's see, come down here. Yeah, if the earthquake had happened there on land, yeah, there would have been a lot of destructions. Buildings shifted off foundation, crack thrown out of plumb. The ground would have opened up. Underground pipes would have been broken. There was 3 reports sent into EMSE. The first one here says, nice one. Newly back to the region. Was awakened in bed prior to the shaking, or they were awake before it shook. Short duration, but a good shake. They were 74 kilometers north. Kino, which is about 46 miles, again, north. The next one was 145 miles north, or 45 kilometers northwest. So that would be about 91 miles. It just says Mexico. Gentle rocking, short duration. We felt this earthquake in Bahia de Los Angeles, BCN. We both happened to wake up right before it started. Huh, now that's interesting, too. That's 2. Another one, 154 kilometers northeast. So that would be 95 miles, again, northeast. My mirror that I have high on the desk began to shake, as well as my rotating acrylic, some kind of jewelry stand. It says it holds necklaces and earrings. Okay, so that's all we got here on EMSC. So it took about 12 hours from the last earthquake that I reported. Like I said, originally they said it was a 3.5, but they downgraded it to a 3.3. 12 hours until there was the 6.1. And it's, yeah, right along the San Andreas Fault Zone. Hope you guys are prepared. Like I said, I don't see any aftershock so far. Yep, yep. So, did you feel this earthquake? If so, please put that information down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support. You know who you are. God bless you. Please stay safe. Always be prepared for some sort of disaster. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.